Okay, what do you get when you pair lobster with a bunch of ridiculously other great shit? You get what we're making today.
You said ridiculously other great shit. It should be other ridiculously great shit.
I don't know if that's true.
Ridiculously other great shit? Come on.
Why can't I?
Do you want me to not correct you?
I don't know for that. That made sense in my head because I said it. And yes, I said more better the other day, and that clearly was a mistake.
It could be a little bit more expensive if it was a little bit more better. I'd be okay with that.
Dad. Okay, I'll redo it. What do you get when you pair lobster with a bunch of ridiculously great shit? You get what we're making today. That was a shameless plug for the Make America Cook Again mug, which of course is a culinary statement. It's not a political statement. I'm not taking sides here. I'd like to. Oh, trust me. I'd like to. But let's just stay in the middle. We all got to get along, right? We're only here for one thing, food. And in today's example, lobster. Big ass fucking lobster tails. I mean, they're not that big. They're like 8 ounces, which is pretty good because, you know, you could buy like 3 ounce lobster tails. I say go big or go home. So 8 ounce, 7 ounce, that's probably the minimum where you should be. You will find 5 ounce in your stores and you'll find 3 ounce. That's like a big ass shrimp. Then fucking buy shrimp. But if you're gonna buy a lobster tail, make it decent size. So here's what we're doing. We're gonna do something called camelback. No, we're not. We're gonna do something called, what did I say it was?
I can't remember now.
Hold on. It's not camelback. It's the other back.
Horseback?
No, not horseback. Not horseback, not hassleback is a potato, a delicious one. Jeez, I'm gonna have to think about this. Camelback.
Is it an animal?
Horseback. I don't even have a phone to look it up on. Hang on.
I'll get it.
Get it. Saddleback? I said saddleback. Camelback? Saddleback! I got it halfway in going to the house for my phone. Saddleback. Saddleback, here's the saddle, you're on the saddle. What we're gonna do is we're gonna pull the lobster out, sit it on top. Look, that's the way the fancy places do it, and we're trying to up your game. You don't have to do this, but I think you're gonna like it when you see it. But we're gonna serve it, we're gonna brush it, we're gonna love it up with a chimichurri, which is really just herbs, oil, and some seasonings. It's gonna be good. Excuse me, I drink from my Make America Cook Again mug. Imagine you could wake up with me. That's a creepy, I didn't mean to say it like that. That came out wrong, right? Imagine you could wake up and enjoy coffee in one of my mugs. So we're gonna put these kids aside for a second. And we're gonna get to making our chimichurri. And everything goes in the processor and it looks like this. First in, parsley. It's an important part of this. Next, a handful of mint. Little handful of fresh oregano. Boy, and that smell is crazy good. Let's go with some fresh ground salt and fresh ground pepper. By the way, I just ordered this. I've had this shape pepper grinder for a long time and kind of ruined it. The salt grinder, same one a viewer gave us a year or so ago. So I go online to buy this, and it used to be a Mario Batali designed grinder. You'd type in Mario Batali grinder and this guy would come up. Doesn't come up anymore. Well, it may come up, but where you can buy it, no mention of Mario Batali. None, because as we all know, he perved his way into anonymity. Allegedly.
It's at the same place as the Kevin Spacey frying pan.
It's the Kevin... the Kevin Spacey frying pan. And the Harvey Weinstein slow cooker. How many times have we watched that stuff? I mean, it's old now because it's out of the news, but have we all said, what the f*** were they thinking? Like inviting an actress to your room and you answer the door in an open bathrobe with nothing on underneath. What the f*** is wrong with people? Honestly. Some garlic. Four more things. A little handful of garlic cloves, peeled. Love that. Some red pepper flake, because we can and should. A nice squeeze of lemon juice, without the seeds, hopefully. Then we'll put the top on, and we blend. Okay, you want to, as they say, scrape the sides down a bit. Smells unbelievable. And then, with the motor running, we'll slowly drizzle in some oil, thereby creating deliciousness. And then give it a little look. And what you're left with is that. And do you have any idea how good that's going to be? So we'll take it out, put it in this bowl. Oh boy, you can smell it from here, and it's gonna be crazy good. All right, so here's the plan for the lobsters. We take our scissors, and we're gonna cut gently up the shell, but between the shell and the lobster meat. We don't wanna cut the lobster meat. If you look in here, and tell me when you can see in here, Max, do you see there's a space there? In fact, I can almost take my finger and poke it in under these layers of shells. So that's where we want to go. We want to cut like this, right here. Snug along, cut. Snug along, cut. And you're living right along this edge, right in between the shell and the meat. You don't want to go down into the meat if you can help it. And you come right to the edge of the tail. And now this is what you've got, okay? So we've not really cut that. I'm gonna open this up a bit, being careful not to disturb the lobster too much. We want to expose the lobster gently, carefully opening the shell. We're doing fine. You're just trying to be careful. You don't want to crack the shell up too much. Now when you're almost there, push this guy back a bit, this guy back a bit. Now you come underneath. This, I don't know what this is called. I call this the breastplate. Now you're gonna go with your fingers in between the meat and that bottom breastplate, very gently. And you wanna release the lobster, just using a finger. Yes, we're fingering this lobster to release the meat. Came out really badly. Carefully. So now that you've opened, gently, all the way, we've taken our fingers down below. Put it in between now the meat and this breastplate on the bottom, gently releasing the lobster. Here's our goal. Now we pull this lobster meat up. We pull the shell closed a little bit, and we just sit this gently on top. And that, ladies and gentlemen, hasselback, camelback. That's why. See? It sits on top and it cooks outside of the shell but stays attached to the shell. So when you deliver it to the table, it's gorgeous. Yes, I could have come down here and cut off these fins, and I should probably do that because they're just now going to be in my way and prevent this from being perfect on the plate. Sorry, lobster, I'm doing this. But there you go. It's lovely. It's on top. We'll prepare our other one, and then we'll heat the grill. Clearly, I don't know if I'm saying camelback or saddleback, but it's saddleback. And, oh, fellas, on we go. First guy on. Second guy will go behind him. So here's what I kind of like about this. I didn't f*** them up. While they're over the heat, the shell is lifting them up, so they're kind of cooking indirectly. We'll just give them a little oil for now. A little touch of oil. We're not going to come in with the heavy guns, being the chimichurri, until they start to cook a little bit more. It's maybe 10-ish minutes. Maybe 10 to 15 minutes for these guys. There's enough seasoning in the chimichurri. You don't need to worry about that now. I've got the heat down sort of medium-ish low. And they're gonna start to do their thing beautifully. I can close the lid on them. And they're there, and they're cooking beautifully. We will start to give them this in a bit. And I'm telling you, this is insane. That will make it insane. But Max, I told you I had a little surprise for you. Because what goes better with a little lobster than a little steak? The chimichurri is unbelievable on like a little flank or a little skirt steak. So I got a little skirt steak. We're gonna have it. So look, this same thing, like the lobster tails. Just a little oil first, little salt and pepper on it will go. Once it starts to get color, then we hit it with the chimichurri. You dig? So just a quick brush. Clearly the oil will help everything stick. Then we come in with some crushed ground salt. And by the way, I've forgotten who gave us that grinder. So whoever did, would you please let us know? We can thank you properly. On both sides, of course. Of course, both sides. If that wasn't obvious, there's no way that's not obvious. Or maybe it is. Maybe you're just starting your cooking world. So, and if this is the beginning of your journey, then we welcome you and we hope that it turns out great. Come on, let's throw this on. Check out what's going on here. Oh my goodness, look at these fellas. Look at this. Look at the color that the shells have turned. The lobster, not there yet, but starting to be very close. We're about halfway on this guy, maybe a little less here. Okay, but let's get the steak going here, shall we? So that is not very thick, certainly at the thinnest end. But even the flat end down here, it's about 3/4 inch. And that means you're not gonna have to cook this very long. We're gonna be 2.5 minutes aside, that's it. Okay, so now we can start putting a little of the chimichurri on these guys. Oh, for God, look at that. Do you see what's happening? The shit's just dripping gorgeously. Do you see this? Do you see that dripping? Do you see that? Goodness gracious. The steak won't get any until we flip it. But you can even see already, look right here. Getting color, but this from about here down is ready to flip, and I don't want it to be ready, so I'm gonna do that. I'm a thinking man. Let's just give this a little turn this way. I don't know if you can tell me that anything looks better than those tails right now. Well, I'm on the edge of glory. Okay, this guy's ready. Oh. Come on now, come on now, come on now. Now this back side, this top side, the grilled side, starts to get some of the chimichurri love. Do you see it just like soaking in? It's just like... Do you know the difference between really good bath towels and shitty bath towels? Bad bath towels are like using paper. Good bath towels absorb. They pull in all the moisture when you get out of the bath or the shower. That's what's happening with that steak right now. It's just sucking in all that amazing garlic and oil and the herbs. It's gonna be tremendous. And this little piece here is ready again. So I'm just gonna turn it up. Yes, this side that doesn't have any chimichurri is gonna get some, but at this point, folks, we're just like hanging and chilling and waiting. And oh, sure, you want a little bit more here? I'll give you a little bit more. Lobster tail, I'm here for you. And by the way, if you were a lobster tail, wouldn't you want this much love and attention? I mean, look, you're already gone. You're already dead. So, might as well. I'm on the edge of glory. And I'm running into some of you. And when everything's ready, off we go. Steak, beautiful. Look at that, Max. Lobster, tail one. Oh my God, look how majestic. Lobster tail two. Come on, let's have some. Okay, here you go. This is the back. Are you ready? Let's do the slow turn reveal. Work it, baby, work it. Oh my gosh. Come on. How do you spell sexy? Oh, I spell it C-H-I-M-I-C-H-U-R-R-I. Or a steak or lobster, whatever. But look it. This is crazy as.
Maybe we should get one of those revolving tables.
Oh, one of those, yeah, the automatic things, yeah. Holy S, Max, come on. I'm like shitting myself wanting this so badly. Okay, so now, come on now, we gotta have a bite. So let's put the kids down here. Let's bring the steak up. You know, we cut against the grain. Grain runs this way. This is important. I know I wanna take a bite, but I need to teach this. You cut with it. Sorry. If you don't cut against the grain and you cut with it, the fibers are just long in your mouth and it's not nearly as tender. So watch, I'll cut this way. Watch, I'll cut this way. Look how beautiful it is. And now I turn it because I want to go this way. The grains run like this. I want to go like this. Look, that's how, I mean, come on. So a little bite of this first. See how that is? Ready? Can you see that? Can you see how perfect that is? It's about 130. Yes, it's a little more than that f***ing ribeye that I did that you all just shit yourselves on. Astro! Sorry. Okay, so. Number one, the steak is deliciously cooked, which maybe doesn't make sense. Tender, the juicy, all great. But the chimichurri on top of that, the chimichurri that you could serve extra on the side so your guests would be able to put even more on like this. It's heaven. It's like a... It's like a garlicky herb oil garden in your mouth on top of the steak, which is amazing. But the real show that we're here for today, ladies and gentlemen, Max's original suggestion, or one of these kids, the lobster tails. We're good. Astro! We were going to do shrimp, and Max went, maybe lobster would be good. So here's lobster. So let's find ourselves a bite. I still have one more. If I have to go over there, that dog is going to have a hard time sleeping tonight. Let's find ourselves a bite. And I have one more surprise left. So let's gently nudge this tail out. Oh, God. It's tender. Oh, my God. For those of you keeping score, hello, little shell. I pulled this off. Somewhere around 135-ish degrees to keep it super tender. Now I want a little bite. Oh God, I could have done that with my fingers. I know how this is gonna be. I'm salivating. So just look. And understand, when I hold that out to the camera, I'm not doing that to tease you, like being mean to a dog. Here, Benji. No, you can't have that. No, this is to show you how luxurious it is, how lovely it is, how great this bite's going to be, which I suppose on some level is teasing. Melting in my mouth. I mean, please. This is glorious. I've had overcooked lobster. Don't overcook your lobster. There's no reason for that. But there is every reason to have one more big ass bite. But remember I said, holy shit. Remember I said I had another idea. I'm gonna make a taco. It's gonna take me 30 seconds. Don't get mad. Are you gonna get mad? No. Because you want this. Little tortilla. on the flat top. While it's on the flat top, let's just cut some of this perfect steak. We only need a little bit, into a couple small bites. Okay? Little lobster. Maybe they're about the same size piece. Okay. Oh my God, it's gonna be so good. All right, now we take a little flour tortilla. Oh, it's hot. We put a little sour cream on it. Look at it melting. We quickly add a little bit of the chimichurri. And then like this. Then the steak. Oh, shit. And then the lobster. Oh, come on now. And then a tiny bit more. It's hot, very hot in my hand. A tiny bit more of the chimichurri on top. Someone stop me before I eat this thing in like a second and a half. Okay, the only thing left to do, hate to say it, is have a bite. One. Oh. It's dripping. It's dripping chimichurri. And why shouldn't it? One, two. I didn't mean that in that sense. I meant it in the... Look, there was nothing complicated about what we did today. Nothing complicated about what we did today. We made the chimichurri. You don't want to do too much at once? Make the chimichurri on a Monday. It's still good. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Buy a couple lobster tails when they're on sale. If they're frozen, who gives a shit? Slowly defrost them in the fridge. Buy a little skirt steak. Do this. I cooked the lobster tails till they were about 135, 40 degrees. I cooked the steak till it was 130. What more do you need to know? Look, get a good instant read thermometer. In fact, let me hand this to Jillie. I just bought this one. She'll put a link. It was about $25, I think. It will make your grilling game better. Thanks for hanging out with us. I got nothing to do but eat. We're going to Tokyo. We'll be in Tokyo July 23rd to the 29th. If you're there, say hi. If you want to see something, let us know. We love friends. See ya. Road to a million. Something fun's gonna happen.